This is Doris from the Art and Nature Center at the Peabody Essex Museum, and today I'm going to show you how to do some paper mache. And what we are going for is making some little pumpkins or apples or gourds. So I've got my inspiration pumpkin right here. These are just some little balloons. I actually used a water balloon for this one and a regular size balloon for this one because they kind of come out different shapes. I've put rubber bands around the balloon to give it those grooves that the pumpkin has naturally on it. And this one I'm gonna squish it a little as I wrap it so it looks like an apple. So I've got lots of scrap paper. This is newsprint type paper. So if you have actual newspapers, those work wonderfully. Tissue paper works okay, but it's a little bit weaker, so you have to do more layers. Any scrap paper will work if you rip it into strips, but newspaper is the easiest to work with for paper mache. So I'm going to use white glue and water to make my paper mache paste. So I'm gonna pour some glue in here and then add some water to it. I want the glue to be a little bit runnier than normal so that it can coat the paper really well. So this should be good. It's still kind of thick, but it's not as thick as just plain old glue. So I'm gonna start with the pumpkin, and I'm going to rip my paper into shreds, dunk them in the glue, and then lay them over this pumpkin form here. And if you do not have a workspace that can get very messy, lay down some extra newspaper or some wax paper so that your pieces don't stick to the table. So I'm just gonna tear my paper into thin strips and dunk them in the glue. And then I like to use two fingers to get the extra off. And then I'm gonna lay them up and down my piece here. And this is just my first coat. I'm probably gonna do three coats of paper mache on here, so you really get it covered. And I'm gonna try and leave an open space at the bottom, so later on I can pull out the balloon and everything down here. The smaller your piece is, the better it will follow the texture that you've got going on. All right, so I've done a good number of layers on this pumpkin here. Now I start making smaller pieces to just cover any cracks. So your final surface should be mostly small pieces because they cover all of those gaps really well and they smooth out the shape. So that's what I'm working on now. Anything like this where there's a pocket, I'm putting a little bit of paper over it, and I've left this spot at the top or at the bottom, depending on how you look at it. And that is where I will eventually pop the balloon. And I wanna make sure it's strong enough around these edges here. So I'm gonna actually, this one I'm gonna fold over. So I just folded over a little bit that was poking out, and I'm gonna do the same with this little bit. And then I'm gonna start making a little round area around with my paper mache to make sure that's nice and rigid for when I go to add my stem later on. So basically, I'm gonna put a bunch of pieces around in a circle here to strengthen this top edge where I want the stem to go. Later, I wanna go around a couple more times to make sure it's nice and strong here. All right, that should be a lot stronger. All right, I'm gonna let this one dry, and I'm gonna start working on my apple. Now this, I want to be a little bit more squished to be an apple shape. So I'm gonna try and use the tape, one, to hold down the balloon tail up here, and two, I think if I put some tape around it, it will hold in this more apple-like shape. And I think that is more of an apple shape. And as I add the paper mache, I can sculpt it a little bit. So back to the beginning. We're dunking and applying. Okay, so my pumpkin is sitting aside to dry, and my apple is sitting aside to dry. And now I'm gonna work on my gourd, and I think I want it to come in a little here, so I'm gonna do the same thing I did with the apple and use a little bit of tape to make it a little more gourd-shaped. And again, I start with the dunking and the paper. I'm gonna start ripping some pieces ahead of time because once my fingers get sticky again, it's real tricky to tear the pieces. You'll notice, especially if you're using newspaper, it likes to rip a certain way. So this is the way the grain's going. So if I try to rip it this way, it starts to pull up to follow the grain. So just rip it into smaller strips first. So working on covering the whole surface first, and then getting the details in there later. So for you all, no time has passed, but I waited overnight for my pieces to dry. And you'll see I poked in the bottom of the apple to give it that kind of base that apples have and that sort of texture at the base that they have. And I added a stem with paper for the apple because that just has to be really thin. And I used the paper mache to cover over the hole. So I'm gonna show you guys how to do that on the gourd and the pumpkin now. Pumpkins have these nice big stems. Sometimes they're a little more curly, sometimes they're shorter or longer. So I am going to make a couple stems for my gourd and my pumpkin. But before I make the stems, I want to get the balloons out. So I have a thumbtack here and a pair of scissors. You can do either. We're gonna use the scissors. And just let all of the air out of the balloon until you can pull it out. So now I have a hollow gourd. I'm gonna show you how to fill over this hole first. I've got some pre-cut little pieces of paper, and I've still got my glue mixture here. I'm gonna put some glue around the hole and then start gluing my paper over top of it, right like that. And I want the paper to be going in a couple different directions for strength. And I'm not dunking these ones in the solution just because I don't want it too soggy or it will re-moisten all of this other paper mache around it. And I do want a good number of pieces of paper over this area so that it's not really thin. And one way I can tell, since there's a hole in both sides, I can look through it to see if light's coming through, and then I'll know how much paper is on there. So I should be able to reuse all these rubber bands that are in here. There we go. So now I have an empty pumpkin as well. Oh, and at this point, if you wanted to add any beads to make this a shaker, now would be a good time to do that. I'm going to make the stems with some tin foil that I have over here. And basically, I just want to create a shape to build my paper mache on top of. I also want my shape to have a wider area at the base so it can go inside and fill this hole here. And I'm gonna curl it so it looks a lot more like a fun pumpkin stem. And then I'm gonna put it inside of my paper mache, and this can be tricky. All right, so I have that inside there. Now I'm going to tape around the base here with my masking tapes. And then when I start gluing, it will really stay. Masking tape is great for paper mache because it's also made of paper. It's a paper tape, and the glue just sticks right to it. All right, so I've got this stem nice and taped in to my pumpkin, and I can start adding the paper mache right on top of it. So I'm gonna brush some glue over this whole surface. And then I'm gonna start adding strips of paper to stabilize it and also to then cover up the tin foil part. And if you want, you don't have to cover the whole stem because you're gonna paint this. So you can paint over the tin foil, but it might have a different quality than painting over the paper. So now we're gonna make the stem for the gourd. And I think what I've learned is it does wanna go over the outside so it stays better. I'm going to do roughly the same thing, leaving extra foil at the base, and then hold them on that way. I want to make sure that these edges are thinner so that I can wrap them around the top of the gourd. It's okay that that's not filled because we'll fill it with the paper mache. And now the paper mache part begins. I'm going to use a couple bigger strips. Get started, and then I'll move into my smaller strips just like before, and then I'll keep adding until it blends with the rest of the gourd shape. But I'm gonna let these dry and work on them later so that I can show you the painting process on my finished apple. So, I am going to paint my apple some nice fall colors. Some of you might recognize this from the bubble bottle video. This is just the bottom of my water bottle, and it makes a really great little paint cup. I have acrylic paints, but you can use any sort except watercolors because those will make it fall apart again. And I'm just gonna paint right onto the surface of my paper mache. I want it to be mostly red, but I like it when they have that little golden area on one side, so I'm gonna add some of my yellow over here. And then you will have some beautiful decorations for the fall season. I hope you guys enjoyed this project. And if you create some pieces of your own, remember to share them with the hashtag pempod or hashtag PBEssex. And I look forward to seeing what you all make. Little golden red apple. Looks good enough to eat, but not really. All right, see you next time. Bye.